Because in a real world environment, your bootstrap.css file will be locked and safe from changes made inadvertently, we're going to create a CSS file that we can use to make changes. To the left of the sources portion of the CSS designer panel, click the plus sign from the selections, choose create a new CSS file. Let's name this file green_style, and then just so you can identify yours as unique, put your initial at the end without a space. Make sure that link is the radio button selected, and then select OK. Now you'll see you've added a green styles, in my case s.css file, to your sources menu. Click File, Save All, and you're ready to make the first change. I'm going to click the item Green News in the navigation bar. To the left of Selectors, I'm going to click the plus sign. I'm going to delete the suggestion compound style that pops up, and I'm going to type dot row space. Space is very important. It means something different without a space. Dot navbar dash default. And then I'm going to click away. And now when I click on navbar, I'm going to give myself a little space here, pull it over a little bit so that I can see my options. And I'm going to click on the background category, which is the fourth from the left under properties. Under background color, I'm going to click the set background color, and I'm going to set the background color of #069, which is actually 006699, but this is hexadecimal shorthand. And I immediately see the change take place. I'm going to click File, Save All. Now, let's create a gradient background for our navigation bar. I'm going to click on the dot row dot navbar dash default, and then I'm going to select under background image the gradient selection option. On the left side of the gradient menu, I'm going to click the top square to the left of the gradient bar, and then in the highlighted color area, I'm going to replace the existing color with 069. I'm going to click on the bottom gradient color stop, and I'm going to replace that with 08A. I'm going to make sure that my linear gradient angle is set to 180 degrees. It is. I'm going to click Enter, and I have created my gradient. I'm going to click File, Save All. Now I'm going to open it up so I can select one of the main menu items. I'm going to make sure my greenstyles.css is selected, and I'm going to click the Add New Selector icon to the left of selectors in my CSS designer panel. Now, I've got part of what I need, so I'm going to, first of all, put my mouse in front of the first period, and I'm going to type period, R-O-W. Make sure to put that space in. Remember, it means something different without the space. Then after navbar-nav, I'm going to put a space and a greater than sign. I hope that's greater than. Then after the list element, I'm going to put a space and the greater than sign again. Now the greater than sign indicates a child selector, and that means I'm selecting elements that are a direct child of another element. In other words, I'm being pretty specific. Remember that I added row in front to supersede any of the default stylings located in my locked bootstrap.css style sheet. And now I'm going to add the following properties to a new border rule. I'm going to select the border properties icon, and I'll start by clicking on the top. My width is 1 pixel. My style is solid. And my color is 0AE. Using the border area in the CSS Designer menu, I've set the top, the right, the bottom, and the left borders inside my navigation menu. I'm going to click File, Save All. Now I'm going to double click on the compound selector that I just created. I'm going to right click and I'm going to copy it. After copying it, at the end, I'm going to add a colon and the word link, no spaces, for the first component of my navigation menu dynamic styling. Because I'm going to have two classes with the same style rule, I can put a comma between them and a space. Now I'm going to control V and a colon and then visited and enter, and I'll click away and I'm ready to add styles. Now to the link pseudo class selector and the visited pseudo class selector. I'm going to click on the link and under text, I'm going to select color and I'm going to put pound FFC as the color property and I'm going to click enter. I'm going to come to my selector area of the CSS Designer. I'm going to click the plus sign to add a new selector. I'm going to paste what I copied and pasted above, and at the end I'm going to add colon hover. Remember, no space. I'm adding my hover pseudo class. I'm going to press enter twice to create the new selector. I'm going to make sure that my hover compound class is selected. I'm going to click background, and I'm going to, below the background image property, I'm going to click the gradient color picker. The top gradient color stop is going to be pound 069. The bottom gradient color stop is going to be 08A. And lastly, we're going to set the linear gradient angle to 0 degrees. I can't always get this accurately, but I love to pull on it. This is fun. There we go. In the text category, under color, I'm going to enter FFF in the color property, which, as we've learned, is really FFF, FFF, because FFF is shorthand. And now I'm going to click File, Save All. Let's center our navigation menu. In our green styles that we have selected under sources, we're going to create a new selector named .row space .nav .navbar -nav. We'll click the plus sign to the left of selector, and then we are going to type .row .nav .navbar -nav, and we'll hit enter. If you don't see any properties available, remember you probably need to uncheck Show Set. And sometimes, depending on your screen size, that can be hidden like this. If you create a new style and don't see any place to do anything, most likely Show Set is checked. Let's uncheck it. Then everything appears that we need. In the Width property, we're going to enter a fixed pixel size of 715. In the Margin property, we're going to enter the shorthand 0 for 0 pixels of margin at the top and at the bottom. Then we're going to space, and we're going to enter auto for an automatic number of pixels on each side so that it will be centered in the space. Something is still hindering it that's located in the locked bootstrap.css style sheet, and it's the float left property. So we have to do something to override that, and we can do that in this .row .nav, .navbar -nav style that we've created. So we're going to scroll down to float, and we're going to click on none. Now, generally, if you're just starting out from scratch, you don't have to do none because that's the default. We're doing none because we want to override the style that's in the bootstrap.css style sheet. Now we're going to create another selector that we're going to name .row.navbar. And remember, .row.navbar with a space means something different than .row.navbar without a space. So be very precise. And we're going to create the margin bottom property and enter 0 pixels. So we'll scroll down to margin bottom, we'll enter 0 pixels, and we'll click enter. Now we're going to go file, save all. Now let's take a look at that last style that we just entered for our dot row dot navbar. We're going to open just our green styles.css. Now you can see that we were able to add just the 0 pixels. And you can see what we've added since beginning to our style sheet. And all of this is overriding existing styles in the bootstrap.css style sheet with its 4,000 plus lines of code that came with Bootstrap.